next point is sadrutaha. It is a good conduct or the moral conduct. So the person who wants the longer, healthier span of life and who wants to achieve the salvations after the death, they have to follow these rules and regulations. That is a sadrutaha. So sadrutaha, it includes mainly dashavida papa karma and other some principles which are to be followed in day-to-day life. Clear? So let us start with the first shloka. Jirne hitam mitam cha adhyat na vegan nireyet palat na vegito anya karyah syat na ajitva sadhya amayan. So sadruta means it's a principled lifestyle, or the it's a principled regime, it's a good health, not health, it is a good conduct or the moral conduct. So what are the things to be done, what are the things not to be done in day-to-day lifestyle? So that comes under sadruta. Okay, so here the first point is, so the sadrut related with the food is, so always one has to take the food after digestion of the previous. Okay, so once the food which is taken previously, if it digests, then only the person has to go for the next. Okay, that is a jirne hitam mitam. Mitam is, so always one has to eat the food which suits that particular person, and it should be in less quantity. Okay, cha adhyat na vegan nirayet balat. So here the word vega is related with the natural urges. Okay, so in the fourth chapter again we are going to discuss in detail regarding Adharaniya and Dharaniya Vedas. So remember here, Vega means the natural urge. So, na Vega nirayet balat. One should not expel the Vegas forcefully. See, Vega means, for example, Purusha Vega, that is the urge for the defecation. Mutra Vega, urge for the micturation. Kshuda Vega, urge for the hunger. Trishna, urge for the thirst. So, na Vega nirayet balat. Balat means forcefully, one should not expel these natural urges. Clear? So this is a good conduct. Na vegito anya karyaha. If the person is feeling any kind of natural urges, at that time, without passing those natural urges, you should not be busy with any other work, or you should not go for any other activities. Clear? Na vegito anya karyaha. Syat. Na ajitva sadhya amaya. So here, the meaning is, one should not neglect the sadhya rogas. Sadhya amaya means the sadhya roga. Na ajitva sadhya amaya. One should not neglect. Okay, one should not neglect the diseases which are easily curable. If the person neglects the easily curable diseases, it may lead to krucha sadhya or asadhya vyadhis. So it's regarding the moral conduct. Okay, so continuation of the same sadrut. Sukartha sarva bhutanam mataha sarva pravrutayah sukamcha na vina dharma tasma dharma parva bhave. So in our life, always we have to follow, or we must follow the proper ritual path. Okay, always we need to follow the path of truth. So the reason is, so each and everyone desires for the happiness. So our life is mainly meant to achieve the happiness. The final happiness is the achievement of the salvations, isn't it? So sukartha sarva bhutanam mataha sarva pravrutayah. Pravruti means activities, any sort of activity. Okay, so all the activities of the living beings are meant for the happiness. Okay, so I am working in this college as a lecturer to fulfill my all desires. That is the happiness, isn't it? So each and every activity of a person, it is basically because of to achieve the happiness. Sukartha sarva bhutanam mataha sarva pravruti. Sukam cha na vina dharma. So the happiness, it cannot be achieved without following the righteousness, without following the path of truth. Okay. Sukam cha na vina dharma. Without following the dharma, the person cannot achieve the sukha, that is happiness. Because as stored in the shastra, dharana dharma. If the person maintains the virtuousness, definitely it will, vice versa, it will protect him, isn't it? So kamcha na vina dharma, tasmat dharma paro bhavet. So always, that's what, always to achieve the happiness, always to achieve the final destination, that is the salvation, one has to follow the path of righteousness. Clear? Bhaktyam kalyani kalyana mitrani seve itaram duragaharu. So these are the sadrut points. Okay. What are the points to be followed in our life? Bhaktya kalyana mitrani, always be devotee of, be affectionate towards the best friends. Always don't cheat your best friends. Kalyana mitrani. Kalyana mitra means the friends who are the good friends, who are the well-wishers. Okay. So bhaktyam is a devotee, affectionate. Bhaktyam kalyana mitrani, always don't leave your close friends. Okay. So be devotee or be affectionate with your good friends. Okay. And vice versa, itaram duragaha. Okay. Whereas you have to avoid the remaining people who are not well-wishers or who doesn't care for you. You have to better leave them. You have to maintain distance from such people, such wicked people. Okay. Bhaktyam kalyani mitrani seve itaram durgaha. Clear? So these are the few sadhut points which are quoted in Ashtanga Sangraha Sutrasthana. So related with the ethical code of conduct. So always speak the truth. So I told you, always we have to follow the path of truth. Do not get addicted to sensory pleasures. So it may be any addictions. Okay. To fulfill our desires, we should not be addicted with any sensory pleasures. Have a positive attitude. Always we should have a good and positive attitude towards the others. Okay. They do not harm anyone. So in any of the competitions, in any of the activity, we should not hurt anyone. We should not harm anyone. So this also comes under sadhruta. In order to speak pleasantly and be kind to everyone. So always have some mercy towards the other people. Be polite and courteous. Okay. So always be polite. Meditate every day to maintain the good health and to maintain the peace of mind. Be patient and observe self-control. Always one should have control over all the panchendriyas. Share your knowledge with others. So always try to share whatever you have the knowledge. So try to discuss with your friends related with the student. So try to discuss with your friends. Try to share your subject always to with your friends. Okay. Do good to self and society. Okay. So always maintain the righteousness to be good to yourself, and also should have the self-assessment knowledge. Okay. As we discussed in the Manasika Roga Chikits, isn't it? So in the same way, you should be helpful to the society also. Being a doctor, it's our responsibility. And finally, serve God and elderly people. So serve God and elderly people means, so that's what in our culture, always waking up early in the morning after the bath, we worship the God and goddesses. And in the same way, so elderly people means, see, as quoted in the Sadhru, so while moving on the road, you should not overtake the elderly people or aged people. So always you have to respect the elderly people or aged people. That's the meaning. So these are the ethical code of conduct. So in the same way, the social code of conduct are talk politely and respectfully to the listener. Okay. This is must, using appropriate words that benefits self and others. Okay. Never contradict the teacher, even if he or she is in angry mood. Sometimes in the classroom, because of the anger, sometimes the teacher or the ma'am may scold you. Huh? So at that time, you should be patient. Okay, you should not behave arrogantly with your teacher. That's the meaning. So that's a good conduct for a student. Never insult a person who is inferior to you. So this is quite common. Do not be jealous of anyone. So especially in the classes or in the friend circle, if anyone is reading good or he is scoring more, means you should not be jealous with such friends. Okay. And help the poor people. Okay. Undertake an activity after considering its long-term effects. Okay. So always do, while doing any of the activity, so you have to think regarding its results also. Okay. As quoted in Shastra, anarambehi karyanam pratama buddhi lakshana. So the first intellectual word is, you should not start any such activity which is going to harm or which is not going to give any result. Anarambehi karyanam pratama buddhi lakshana. And the second intellectual word is arabdastu antagamanam dvitiya buddhi lakshana. So arabdastu antagamanam means, so once you firmly decides to do that particular work, means, so you should not live in between. So that is the second intellectual word. Clear? Regarding the moral conduct, code of conducts are avoid company of the bad people. As I told you, no? Bhaktyam kalyane mitrani itaram duraga. Clear? Keep a balance between happy and unhappy conditions. So always be stable with mind and the body in both the condition, in sukha and dukkha, that is happy and unhappy situations. Always try to forgive. Okay. So the forgiveness is must for, especially for the doctors, and it is common for all the human beings. Okay. Try to always forgive the others, the minor mistakes. Think of betterment of all creatures. Okay. Help the poor people, unprivileged and diseased people. Being a doctor, this is must for a vaidya. Do good deeds and contribute your wealth and energy for the betterment of society. Clear? So these are some basic code of conducts for everyone. Okay. Next one is regarding the bad deeds. So here, most of the time in the examination, they have given this question as a dashavida papa karmas. So total 10 sinful activities. Out of 10 sinful activities, the first three are related with our body, and the next four are related with our speech, and the last three are related with our mental attitude. Okay, total 10 sinful activities are the papa karmas, the sinful activities. Okay, so those are himsa, asteya, anyata, kamam, paishunyam, parusha, anrutaha, sabhinna alapam, vyapataha, abhidya, druk, pipareyam, papam, karmeti, dashadaha, kaya, va, manasaihi, teji. So always one has to avoid these 10 types of dashavida papa karma, which belongs to kaya, vacha, and manasa. So first one is himsa. Himsa is causing the injury or torturing the others. Okay, or violence. That is a himsa. Next one is asteya. Asteya is stealing. Stealing the things which belongs to someone else. Third one is anyata kama. See, anyata kama means desiring for the things which belongs to someone else. So that is the anyata kamaha. Otherwise, in general, you can consider unlawful sexual activities can be considered as anyata kamaha. Clear? Then paishunyaha. So paishunya vachanaha. Here it is related with speech. Paishunya vachana. Paishunya vachana means abusing words, using harsh words, or the abusing words. Parusha vachanaha, harsh speech, or the harsh, using harsh words. Okay. Anrutaha, speaking lie. Are telling lies or untruth. Then sambhinna alapaha. So related with the speech, the last one is sambhinna alapaha. Irrelevant speeches. Okay. So irrelevant speeches are irrelevant talk. Okay. And the last three, which are related with manas, are vyapataha. Vyapata is quarreling. Okay. Quarreling with someone. Then abhidya. Abhidya is the jealous. Abhidya is jealous. And finally, the last one is druk viparyaya. Druk viparyaya means always finding the faults in someone. Okay. So druk viparyaya means it is finding faults in someone. That is a faithlessness. So that is a druk viparyaya. So these are the total 10 दशविध पापकर्मास आउट ऑफ विच फर्स्ट थ्री आर रिलेटेड विथ बॉडी, नेक्स्ट फोर आर रिलेटेड विथ स्पीच एंड द लास्ट थ्री आर रिलेटेड विथ मनस. And in continuation of the sadrut, the next shloka is aruttihi vyadi shokartam anuvartate shaktitah. So anuvartate shaktitah means as much as possible we try to help these people. Okay, we need to help these people. That is aruttihi. Aruti means the person who doesn't have any work, who doesn't have any anything for to live his livelihood. For such people, we try to help as much as possible. That is aruttihi, vyaditaha, the person who is suffering from diseases. Shokartaha, who is affected with the grief. For such people, we need to help as much as possible. Aruttihi, vyadihi, then shokartan, anuvartate shaktitah. The next shloka is atmavat satatam pashyet api kita pipilikam. So always we have to respect each and everyone, including insects and the animals. So atmavat satatam. Atmavat satatam means, so we have to respect each other. Clear? It may be a minute insect or it may be any animal, whatever it may be. We have to think each and everyone equally. We have to treat each and everyone equally. Clear? So that's the meaning here. Atmavat satatam pashyet. Kita pipilika. Pipilika is the ant. Okay. So actually I have chosen few points from Sadrutaha. Okay, some important points from Sadrutaha. Next comes the Archayet Deva Go Vipra Rudra Vaidya Nrupa Atithi. So always one has to treat or always one has to worship the Deva, that is God and the goddesses, Go, that is cow, Vipra, Brahmanas, Rudra, aged people, Vaidya, physician, Nrupa, king, and the Atithis, guests. Okay. So always we should respect and worship these people. That is Archaya, Deva, Go, Vipra, Rudra, Vaidya, Nrupa, and Atithi. Clear? Then the same way, Vimukan, Arthin, Kuryat, Navamahanet, Na Affection. So always, one should not send the beggars on empty hands. Okay, so beggars should not be disappointed. As much as possible, you try to help each and everyone, including the beggars also. You should not use the abusing words towards the beggars. Okay, or you should not object the beggars. Okay, that is the meaning. So these are the code of conduct as quoted in Ashtangaraya Sutras. Next one is, this is the last point related with the Sadrutaha. So better you had this shloka. So if you get the question related with the Sadrut for 10 marks, so you quote this shloka along with explanation of the remaining points. Okay. Ardra Santanata Tyagaha Kayava Chetasam Damaha. Ardra Santanata Tyagaha Kayava Chetasam Damaha Swartha Buddhihi Parardeshu Paryaptamiti Sadrutam. So in Sadrut point, so this shloka is very important one. So Sadrut is the moral conduct or the good conduct. Ardra Santanata means we should have mercy towards each and everyone. We should have the respect, the helping nature towards each and everyone. We should have affectionate behavior with each and everyone. Tyagaha, we should have the quality of sacrificing the things, okay, for the happiness of others. Kaya vak chetasam damaha, we should have the control over the activities or the actions related with body, mind, and the speech. So as I quoted in the Dashavidha Papa Karma, one has to avoid, but one has to try to control those dashavidha papakarma. Kayavak chetasam dhammaha. Swartha buddhi pararteshu. Swartha buddhi pararteshu means should treat each and everyone equally. We should take the responsibility of each and everyone. That's the meaning here. So as those people also, as others also, we should think as their own. Okay. In the same way, we have to consider each and everyone as much as possible. We need to help everyone. That is swartha buddhi parateshu. Paryaptamiti satruptam. These are the basic code of conducts to be followed to maintain the good health and happiness in the life. Okay. And the conclusion for the Dinacharya Adhyaya is iti acharaha. If the person follows all these regime related with the food, regime related with the activities. Okay. As I told you, achara labate ayu. Why we have to follow these regimes means to achieve the happiness, to achieve the longer healthy span of life, isn't it? Iti acharaha. If the person follows this kind of regime, then iti acharaha samasena properly. Yam praptnoti samacharan ayuhu arogya aishwaryam yasho lokascha shashvata. If the person follows this achara, that is aharjacharya, viharjacharya, and sadrutaha. Sadrut means it comes under viharaja acharana. So if the person follows these moral conducts or the good conducts or these principles, definitely he will achieve the healthy, longer span of life, that is ayura arogyam, aishwaryam. Even he will achieve the wealth also, and yashaha. Yashaha is he will achieve a good reputation, good success in the life. Lokascha shashvatam, which is eternal in this world. And finally, the person will achieve the final happiness, that is the salvation. Salvation is considered as the eternal happiness in this world. Okay, with this, it completes the Dinacharya Adhyaya. Okay.